Good morning, everyone. So today we will be starting chapter number 2, that is nutrition in animals. I told you in chapter number 1, what is nutrition? Nutrition means the method of taking food and using it to obtain energy. Now, if I talk about animals, you all know that animals are heterotrophic. It means they cannot make their own food. They take their food either from plants or they take their food from the animals, and then that animal would have eaten the plant. So animals are heterotrophic. Now, next topic is different ways of taking food. If you will see among animals, they take their food in different ways. Suppose I'll give you few examples. First is infant of human beings. Infant means young babies. Infant of human beings, they used to suck the mother's milk. So that is their way of taking food. Second, some snakes like python. You must be aware how python takes its food. It swallows its entire food. So it uses the method swallowing, while the infant one uses the method of sucking, right? Now next example, hummingbird or bees. You are aware about the bees. They used to suck the nectar of flowers. So again they are using sucking type of behavior. Some aquatic animals, what they used to do, they used to filter the water. Obviously, aquatic animals, they used to live in the water. So in the water, some tiny food particles are present. So these animals, they used to filter that water and then they used to eat that food. So different type of organisms take food in different way. I'll give you one more example of starfish and very interesting feature. While the animals which are covered with hard shell, the shell is made up of calcium carbonate. These type of animals which are covered by calcium carbonate shell, these type of animals, these are the food of starfish. Now what the starfish used to do, firstly starfish will open the calcium carbonate shell of the animal, right? Inside that shell, the soft animal is present. Now starfish is supposed to eat that soft animal which is present inside the shell. Now what it will do, it will pop out its stomach from its mouth. Means the stomach of starfish will come out from its mouth. It's an interesting feature. Its stomach will come out from its mouth. That stomach, it will eat that animal. And then again this stomach will go back into the mouth. So this is the topic how different animals used to take food. Now our next topic is nutrition. Basically what are the different steps in nutrition? Okay. If you see in nutrition, there are 5 steps. First step is ingestion. Second step is digestion. Third step is absorption. Fourth step is assimilation. And last step is egestion. Now what are the meaning of these? Clear? First is ingestion. As the word suggests, in means inside. So the process of taking the food into your mouth, that is ingestion. Suppose you are eating a chapati. You just took a bite and you just put it in your mouth. This is what is ingestion. The process of taking the food into the mouth or the process of taking the food into the body is known as ingestion. Now digestion. Whatever food you are eating, that is very complex. Complex means a kind of a difficult structure that your body cannot use. Suppose you are eating carbohydrate, your body cannot use that carbohydrate. You are eating protein, your body cannot use protein. So what your body used to do in this process in digestion, the complex substances of food, they're broken into simple substances. And these simple substances can be used by your body. Like carbohydrates, they are broken down into simple sugars like glucose. The third step is absorption. Absorption means to take in. In absorption, the digested nutrients, they are taken in by your blood. In first step, ingestion means the process of taking food into the body. Digestion, the process of breaking the food into simple substances that can be taken by your body. Absorption means the process of taking the digested nutrients by the blood. Assimilation. Assimilation means using. In absorption, your body has taken the nutrients. Okay. Now in assimilation, your body will use the nutrients. And why your body will use the nutrients? For what purpose your body will use the nutrients? Right. For energy, for growth, and for development. So in assimilation, the absorbed nutrients, the taken in nutrients, they will be used by your body for energy, for growth, for maintenance, and for various other purposes. Now egestion. Egestion means to expel out, to remove out. After all these processes, obviously there will be some waste products, or you can say undigested food. The undigested food or the waste materials, they have to be thrown out of your body. And the process of removing the waste from your body is known as egestion. So these are the different processes of nutrition. Ingestion, the process of taking food. Digestion, the process of breaking food. Absorption, the process of taking the digested nutrients into the blood. Assimilation, the process of using the digested nutrients for growth, energy, and egestion, the process of removing the harmful waste products or the undigested food from your body. Thank you.